Hello everyone. My name is Michael Child and I work for the Neo Carbon Energy Project with the Solar Economy Group at Lappeenranta University of Technology. The main aim of my work is to examine the transition of the Finnish energy system towards long-term sustainability. Today I will talk about the role of 100% renewable energy systems in achieving carbon neutrality as a way of mitigating the effects of climate change. This is the second of two short videos that examine the elements of a 100% renewable energy system. This time, we will finish our discussion by integrating the electricity sector with the mobility sector. At this point, we have an improved energy system that has eliminated fossil fuels, but there's still work to be done. We have not fully addressed the possible imbalance between energy supply and energy demand, nor have we addressed the mobility sector. In this video, we will address both issues and also look at cost aspects of our new 100% renewable energy system. Our demands for mobility have traditionally been supplied by petroleum products, particularly gasoline, diesel, and kerosene. Certainly other fuels have been used, but these fossil fuels comprise the vast majority. The first step towards integrating the electricity and mobility sectors will therefore be the widespread introduction of electric vehicles. An important aspect of the electrification of mobility is an immediate increase in fuel efficiency. Electric vehicles are more than 3 times more fuel efficient than vehicles which use combustion engines. This, again, results in decreased pressure on energy resources, particularly biomass. What is more, the batteries of electric vehicles offer a significant storage opportunity for the energy system. As such, not only will these batteries be able to store a great deal of electricity at times of excess, it will also be possible to transfer the energy stored in such batteries back to the energy grid at times when demand exceeds supply. The level at which people will participate in such vehicle-to-grid connections is still unknown, and people may require some incentives for participation. But the potential flexibility offered by electric vehicles and vehicle-to-grid connections is tremendous. High levels of electrified mobility and vehicle-to-grid connections will result in changes to and challenges for local and national electricity grids, some of which are just beginning to be understood in detail. However, these challenges appear manageable. Overall, vehicle-to-grid offers both an abundance of storage and represents a significant potential for flexibility in mobility demands. Some aspects of mobility may prove difficult or even impossible to electrify, so other fuels need to be considered. In particular, air travel, large truck transport, and international shipping will require the use of more traditional fuels that can be stored in onboard or stationary reserve tanks. The same may be true for the mobility fuel demands of global military and emergency services. For these important aspects of mobility, more traditional gaseous and liquid fuels will be required. In a 100% renewable energy system, these storable fuels can be produced synthetically. As stated previously, biomass can be used to create all of these fuels that are currently being used in transport. Already around the world, portions of transport fuels are so-called biofuels. In some parts of the world, for example Brazil, biofuels are already used extensively. However, we must remember that sustainable biomass resources are limited, and that it may not be possible everywhere. There are several alternatives to using biomass-based transport fuels. These alternatives may also prove to be useful in other parts of the energy system, thereby representing flexible and storable energy carriers. The first option is to utilize fuels that are currently used to a small extent, such as hydrogen or methane. Both fuels can be produced by utilizing excess electricity. Hydrogen can be produced by the process of electrolysis, which utilizes electricity and water as resources. Synthetic methane can be produced from the combination of hydrogen and carbon dioxide in a process called methanation. Carbon dioxide can be captured from a variety of sources, including ambient air. Both electrolysis and methanation involve the production of heat, which can be harnessed for use in district heating systems. These processes are the essence of the concept of power to gas. Other methods of synthetic fuel production involve the concept of power to liquids, which involves the production of synthetic gasoline, kerosene, methanol, ethanol, and diesel, as well as a variety of other hydrocarbons, such as naphtha, waxes, and olefins. When considering that power can be used to create a variety of chemical products, the concept is often referred to as power to chemicals, or PTX. Products from which can be used both within the energy system and in other industrial or agricultural contexts. Each of the products mentioned represent two important aspects needed in a 100% renewable energy system: storability of fuels and flexibility of demands. Similarly, excess power can be used to create potable water in regions of the world that experience water stress. The main idea behind this concept is to use electricity in seawater reverse osmosis plants to turn salt water into fresh water that is suitable for drinking, cleaning, and agricultural purposes. Desalination, therefore, represents yet another flexible demand for electricity. At the same time, the energy system becomes integrated with another important aspect of society. A final element of flexibility for a 100% renewable energy system can come from various forms of electricity storage. Elements of electric storage already familiar to current energy systems are hydro dams and pumped hydro storage, or PHS. PHS systems have often been associated with hydro dams, whereby excess electricity can be used to pump water back into the reservoirs behind the dams so that energy can be used at another time. However, a number of dedicated PHS systems also exist in places where water reservoirs can be located at high elevations. And there are also possibilities to utilize caves and abandoned mines for PHS systems. Another important aspect of electric storage for future energy systems will be battery storage. We have already discussed the possible significant role of the batteries of electric vehicles, but stationary batteries may also become widespread in an environment of home or community-based distributed electricity generation. The Tesla Powerwall has already emerged as an example of a home-based system for electricity storage. And advances in lithium-ion battery technology offer great potential for the future for affordable, small-scale electric storage. Developments with flywheels and supercapacitors may offer even further potential for larger-scale electricity storage. As has been demonstrated, it is possible to substitute the great flexibility and storability of fossil fuels with flexibility and storage found in a 100% renewable energy system. Imbalance between supply and demand do not need to occur in a well-planned system. A 100% renewable energy system can be fully functional and reliable. The key questions that remain involve whether such a system is economically desirable, as well as whether it would be an overall benefit to society. Several research studies have concluded that the overall cost of energy in a 100% renewable energy system may at best be less expensive, and at worst, not significantly higher in cost than one based on fossil fuels. My own research can be combined with that of others from the solar economy team at LUT, and other such conclusions reached about Ireland and Denmark by colleagues at Aalborg University. This can be combined with findings from Agora Energiewende, the Rhine-Lemoyne Institute, and Fraunhofer Institute in Germany. What is more, the overall energy system cost structure is very different in a 100% renewable system. Energy systems based on fossil fuels often involve high costs for imported fuels. Meanwhile, 100% renewable energy systems involve high levels of investment in domestic technologies and other domestic activities. From a social perspective, this could also mean a great deal of domestic job creation and the improvement of national trade balances. This could also facilitate technological sharing between nations to replace political tensions that are sometimes associated with the international trade of fossil fuels. This could also create more energy equality and more energy justice on a global level. A last key question must also be asked. Are there alternatives to a 100% renewable energy system? The obvious answer is yes. Firstly, discussions of future energy systems often involve the possibility of utilizing carbon capture and storage, or CCS, technology. In addition, the role of nuclear energy has not yet been discussed. This is also a common topic when discussing energy systems. A full discussion of these technologies will not be attempted in this video, other than to stipulate that these technologies will be part of the overall discourse on future energy systems. In the current discussion of a 100% renewable energy system, there is demonstration of carbon capture and utilization in place of carbon capture and storage. As well, nuclear energy involves the use of uranium as a fuel, which is a finite and not a renewable resource. For this reason, this technology will fall outside of the scope of a discussion on 100% renewable energy systems. I'd now like to conclude by acknowledging that this discussion, however complex, was not meant to be exhaustive. There are more resources and technologies that currently represent minor opportunities in the energy system that have not been included in this analysis. We must also acknowledge that there may be innovations and inventions that we cannot yet foresee, but that may represent significant game changers in future energy systems. The future is full of possibilities. One of the most human of qualities is our ability to be both adaptive and creative in the face of change. A fully successful mitigation strategy for climate change can be found. Indeed, one could argue that it must be found. My personal view is that a 100% renewable energy system can be an integral part of that strategy. I hope you now have a deeper understanding of how such a system might work. Thank you very much for watching.